turn on my mic and my camera. So I'm having a great day so far. Hey, everybody, it is Monday. It is January 29th. It is the last quiz of the month of January 2024. How is everybody doing today? I hope that you've had a great weekend and a great month so far. We are going to do our usual Monday night Twitch quiz. Oh, a new follower. I can never read those on the screen. Oh, TS Master giving out 4 community subs. Thank you, sir. You do that so well. How did Micah lose a million? Because of Fluffy Flapjacks. Fluffy Flapjacks. That's how he lost $1 million. Micah was supposed to be here tonight, but he's off spending the $30,000 that he won on Wheel of Fortune. So I don't begrudge him that. And, you know, I like hosting. We are just about ready to get started with everything. I hope everybody is having a good Monday. I hope everybody has a drink in hand. I myself am drinking a Gatorade Zero because I'm sure, as everybody knows, I don't drink alcohol. We are going to get started. We're going to do 7 rounds of Geeks Who Drink over the next couple of hours. We have 7 rounds of 8 questions each for you to answer. All of our rounds have 8 questions, but not all of our rounds are worth 8 points. In fact, 3 of our rounds this evening are worth 16 possible points, specifically round 2, round 6, and round 7. All 3 of those rounds are worth 16 possible points. That comes into play when you decide how you want to use your joker. Every team or every player who's playing solo has a joker that you can use to double the points for 1 round this evening. You can only use it to double the points for a single round. Once you use it, it's gone. You could use your joker on an 8-point round and get a possible 16 points, and that's fine. Or you could use your joker on a 16-point round and get a possible 32 points, and that's almost always the difference between teams winning and not winning. So, you know, I'm not your real dad. Make your own best life decisions and joker the round that you feel the most confident about. I think that's pretty much all of the important stuff. A couple of rules for you. You know, don't put any answers in the chat. Don't yell out the answers in the chat. Don't give away answers. But then again, if somebody does, don't forget that we have exclamation point shame to shame them for doing that. If you need something to keep your score on, you can do exclamation point score sheet in the chat and have a handy dandy score sheet to track all of your answers and your possible points for a round. And if you've never played Geeks Who Drink before, it's pretty simple. Just answer the questions, don't put the answers in the chat, and I will give you the correct answers at the end of each round so that you can tally up your scores at the end of the evening. Everybody's got a drink, everybody's having fun. Micah was awesome on Wheel of Fortune. It was a good show. And, yeah. I think we're all ready to get started, so if you guys want to play a little bit of quiz, just go ahead and shout out, "Let's do it," in the chat, and we'll jump right into round number 1. Don Rico Suave, he got wedge cut french fries. Let's go from Don Rico Suave. All right, let's go ahead and jump right into the quiz proper and get into round number 1. Round number 1 tonight is you get a car. You get a car, you get a car, you get a car. Everybody gets a car. Disclaimer, Geeks Who Drink is not giving anybody a fucking car tonight. Happy 70th birthday, Oprah. And in her honor, every answer will contain car somewhere within it. Happy 70th birthday, Oprah. In her honor, every answer tonight will contain car somewhere within it. Round 1, question number 1. In the autobiography, Making It So, which is a very good read, Patrick Stewart recalls having his toupee flown in from England to help him audition for what Starfleet captain? In the autobiography, Making It So, Patrick Stewart recalls having his toupee flown in from England to help him audition for what Starfleet captain? I prefer the Bees version of the Oprah car. The words Taylor Swift, let's F and go. You know what? It's really nice to see that Taylor Swift's boyfriend has made it all the way to the Super Bowl. I feel that with her love and support behind him that he may go all the way. So congratulations to Taylor Swift's boyfriend for getting into the Super Bowl. Let's move on to question number 2. Number two, a role she'd revisit in Hustlers. What Bongo's rapper got fired from an Amish market in Tribeca only to immediately start working at the strip club across the streets? For a third time, AJ. Come on, guys. It's Taylor Swift's boyfriend. We're all going to love him. We're all going to support him, right? Like, go whatever your team is. I don't remember. And whoever you're playing. I think the 49ers and somebody else. Whatever team he's on, I'm sure he's on the 49ers or something. Let's move on to question number three. Number three, saying it can confuse people. The Center for Health Journalism wants reporters to stop calling the Affordable Care Act by what presidential name? Saying it can confuse people, the Center for Health Journalism wants reporters to stop calling the Affordable Care Act by what presidential name? I will say about the Taylor Swift, Travis Kelce stuff, my favorite thing that I have seen this week is somebody going to Target, buying like a $75 copy, a repress vinyl of Taylor Swift's 1989, and smashing it on the sidewalk outside Target because apparently he's so upset that they turned the cameras on her during football games. So, I mean, she still gets paid. Who cares if you smashed it? Moving on to question number four. Number four, in honor of the dude who invented the first non-toxic eyelash improver, Rebel is the Spanish word for what makeup product? In honor of the dude who invented the first non-toxic eyelash improver, Rebel is the Spanish word for what makeup product? I'm so mad I could financially support this person, brand, company, etc. Like, right? Like, there are many, many better ways to protest, like, something that you don't like. I don't know. Take a knee. Let's move on to question number five. Number five tonight, trying it out for the first time back in 1475, the Dalai Lama claims that he's pulled off what supernatural accomplishment 13 different times. Trying it out for the first time back in 1475, the Dalai Lama claims he's pulled off what supernatural accomplishment 13 different times. They didn't call him Dirty Harry for nothing, I guess. Question number six of round one. Question number six. Just grab a shell with tongs, pull the flesh out with a specialized snail fork, and bon appetit! That's how Food Republic says to eat what Frenchest of all delicacies. Just grab a shell with tongs, pull the flesh out with a specialized snail fork, and bon appetit! That's how Food Republic says to eat what Frenchest of all delicacies. All right, as Chaz would say, it's the penultimate question of our first round, number seven. Question number seven tonight, will you do the Fandango? Wikipedia's list of humorous units of measurement includes what 11-day term named for a short-tenured White House communications director? Well, you do the Fandango. Wikipedia's list of humorous units of measurement includes what 11-day term named for a short-tenured White House communications director? All right, final question, first round, question number 8. And I do have your first bonus question of the evening. And don't worry, if you're a brand new player, I'll explain how the bonuses work in a moment as well. Question number 8. Recreating his viral 2012 photo, last year Lenny Kravitz uploaded his first ever TikTok wearing what iconic oversized winter accessory? Recreating his viral 2012 photo last year, Lenny Kravitz uploaded his first ever TikTok wearing what iconic oversized winter accessory? Everybody, it's time for what you've been waiting for with bated breath. It is our first bonus question of the evening. The way the bonuses work is I will give you until the answer for question number 7 to submit your answers. The way you submit an answer for a bonus question is do an exclamation point and then your answer in the chat. If you think your answer should be more than one word, you're going to remove any spaces and punctuation. You're going to take it, you're going to just smash it all together. I just wanted to make you think I froze. We're going to move on and get to the first bonus question. A Camaro, not an El Camino, headlined the showcase that Aaron Paul overbid on by just $132 in a pre-fame appearance on what game show? A Camaro, not an El Camino, headlined the showcase that Aaron Paul overbid on by just $132 in a pre-fame appearance on what game show? I think you guys have it all figured out, so why don't we go ahead and move on to some answers for our first round this evening. Round number 1, that was the round we just did. You get a car. Round 1, question number 1. In the autobiography Making It So, Patrick Stewart recalls having his toupee flown in from England to help him audition for what Starfleet captain? Well, baby, that's Jean-Luc Picard. Question number 2. Oh, by the way, if you haven't read Making It So and you love Patrick Stewart as much as I do, I recommend the audiobook version because nothing quite tops having Patrick Stewart read his life story to you. Question number 2. A role she'd revisit in Hustlers. What Bongo's rapper got fired from an Amish market in Tribeca only to immediately start working at the strip club across the street? That's Cardi B. Question number 3. Saying it can confuse people, the Center for Health Journalism wants reporters to stop calling the Affordable Care Act Obamacare. I think we're stuck with Obamacare, guys. Nothing's going to change that. Number 4. In honor of the dude who invented the first non-toxic eyelash improver, Rimmel is the Spanish word for mascara. Number five, trying it out for the first time back in 1475, the Dalai Lama claims that he's pulled off what supernatural accomplishment 13 different times? That's reincarnation. And number six, just grab a shell with tongs, pull the flesh out with specialized snail fork, and bon appetit! That's how the French Republic says to eat escargot. And question number seven, will you do the fandango? Wikipedia's list of humorous units of measurement includes what 11-day term name for a short tenured White House communications director? That is Scaramucci, but the unit of measurement is mooch. And the final question and answer number eight. Question number eight. Recreating his viral 2012 photo last year, Lenny Kravitz uploaded his first ever TikTok wearing what iconic oversized winter accessory? That's a scarf. And it's time for the bonus question answer. As always, the winners of our bonus question in tonight's quiz get a $5 credit to use at the Geeks Who Drink Shopatorium, that is the Geeks Who Drink merch shop, and you're also entered into a drawing at the end of the night to win a big old Geeks Who Drink swag box. Our bonus question was, a Camaro, not an El Camino, headlined the showcase that Aaron Paul overbid on by just $132 in a pre-fam appearance on The Price is Right. Price is Right. Round number two is going to be our first 16-point round this evening. Don't forget we have three 16-point rounds, round two, round six, and round seven. All of our other rounds are worth 8 points this evening. Round two, round six, and round seven are the rounds you should probably think about using your joker for. Our theme for round two tonight is ozone. Ozone. Name the artist and song titles, and don't worry, you'll see what we're doing in this round. Just name the artist and song titles. It's 1 point for the artist, 1 point for the song title. If you only know one, but not the other, you should still put it down because you do get a point for that. If you really like your answers in round two, you might use your joker to double your points. Otherwise, don't forget six and seven are our other 16-point rounds. We're going to run all eight audio clips for you twice back to back. Let's hit it. We'll be right back. So why don't we go ahead and just get right to it with the answers for round number two. Round number two, that's the ozone. Some answers, starting with number one. That is Crazy in Love by Beyonce featuring Jay-Z. Number two, that is Circles by Post Malone. Number three, it is No One by Alicia Keys. Number four, it is Viva La Vida by Coldplay. Number five is Bailado by Enrique Iglesias and pretty much everybody else. Number six, While My Guitar Gently Weeps by the Beatles. And number seven, it's Elastic Heart by Sia. Number eight, You Can't Touch This by MC Hammer. I prefer Too Legit to Quit. But those are all of our answers for round number two. So why don't we go ahead and move on to round number three. Round number three tonight is an 8-point round, so if you didn't use your joker in round two, really, seriously, consider saving it for later in the quiz. Theme for round three tonight is Half in the Bag, Full Speed Edition. Half in the Bag, Full Speed Edition. Each question is a short clue about a two-word phrase, and we give you one of the words. You simply have to fill in each blank. Each question is a short clue about a two-word phrase, and we give you one of those words. You simply fill in each blank. That's it. Fill in the blank. Question number one. The claymation film whose Dawn of the Nuggets sequel dropped last year. What run? The claymation film whose Dawn of the Nuggets sequel dropped last year. What run? Question number two of round three. Number two, kind of surprisingly, the NFL's lowest paid offensive position. Running what? Kind of surprisingly, the NFL's lowest paid offensive position. Running what? Running nose. Question number three of round three. Number three. The hip-hop grandpas behind It's Tricky and Rock Box. Run what? The hip-hop grandpas behind It's Tricky and Rock Box. Run what? Mm-hmm. 10 out of 16. That's not bad, Olive's Mom, 615. Question number four of round three. Number four, the reality show where Bear Grylls tested the survival skills of Shaq and Barack Obama. Running what? The reality show where Bear Grylls tested the survival skills of Shaq and Barack Obama. Running what? Question number five. Number five of round three. Another name for patellofemoral pain syndrome. Runners, what? Another name for patellofemoral pain syndrome. Runners, what? Question number six. Number six of round three. Question number six. The unofficial New York to LA speed race that's never been conquered by Burt Reynolds. What run? The unofficial New York to LA speed race that's never been conquered by Burt Reynolds. What run? And second to last question of round number three, it's question number seven. Number seven, the submarine trick of switching off non-vital systems to evade passing ships. What? Running. The submarine trick of switching off non-vital systems to evade passing ships. What? Running. Final question. Gabbo, that's terrible. That is awful. Question number eight. Final question, round three. Number eight. The Shel Silverstein hare who speaks almost entirely in spoonerisms. Runny, what? The Shel Silverstein hare who speaks almost entirely in spoonerisms. Runny, what? Is that working? Am I coming through? Do you got me back? Let me know in the chat if you hear me, if you see me, if the quiz is working again, because Xfinity is a nightmare for me as much as it is for everybody. Xfinity, please sponsor us. We could always use that money. But your service is terrible. All right, I'm back. I'm live. I am here. Spectrum is not worse. I have had Spectrum, but it is just as bad as Xfinity. All right, we got all the way to question eight. The Shel Silverstein hare, who speaks almost entirely in spoonerisms, runny, what? And that being the end of round three, we're going to just go right into our next bonus question. Bonus question, as always, the winner of the bonus question gets a $5 credit to use the Geek String Shopatorium and entered into a drawing at the end of the night for a big old Geeks Who Drink swag box. Do exclamation point and your answer in the chat. Do exclamation point and your answer in the chat. If you think your answer is going to be more than one word, you're going to remove any spaces, punctuation, and everything and smash it all together. And we're going to go ahead and move on to the bonus question. Bonus question! Wrapping its 20th season last year, what reality competition used to film during summer breaks at the Parsons School of Design? Wrapping its 20th season last year, what reality competition used to film during summer breaks at the Parsons School of Design? Trying to think you guys got it all figured out. Why don't we go ahead and get into some answers for round number three. Round number three, that's the round that we read, half an hour ago. Round number three, our theme for that was Half in the Bag, Full Speed Edition. Round three answers, starting with number one. The claymation film whose Dawn of the Nugget sequel dropped last year. What? Run. Chicken Run. Number two, kind of surprisingly, the NFL's lowest paid offensive position, is the running back. Number three, the hip-hop grandpa's behind It's Tricky and a rock box that's Run DMC. Number four, the reality show where Bear Grylls tested the survival skills of Shaq and Barack Obama, that's Running Wild. Number five, another name for patellofemoral pain syndrome, runner's knee. Number six, the unofficial New York to LA speed race that's never been conquered by Burt Reynolds, that's the Cannonball Run. Number seven, the submarine trick of switching off non-vital systems to evade passing ships, that is silent running. Silent running. And question number eight. Number eight, the Shel Silverstein hare who speaks almost entirely in spoonerisms, that is Runny Babbitt. Runny Babbitt. And it's time for our bonus question. Bonus question wrapping up its 20th season last year. What reality competition used to film during summer breaks at the Parsons School of Design? That's Project Runway. Our theme for round four tonight is going to be, I'm going to give you some terrible thrills. I'm going to give you some terrible thrills. Round four is another 8-point round, so if you still have a joker, save it for round six or seven, guys. I'm going to give you some terrible thrills. Famous burlesque gal Lily St. Cyr died on this date. So here's a whole round on other people and things mentioned in Rocky Horror Picture Show songs. Famous burlesque gal Lily St. Cyr died on this date. So here's a whole round on other people and things mentioned in Rocky Horror Picture Show songs. Fun fact, I emceed Rocky Horror for over a decade across three states. I loved every minute of it, but I can't do that anymore. That is way too high energy for me. Let's get into it with question number one. Number one, saying it would have been a tortuous experience, 90-year-old Scream Queen Faye Ray passed on the role of Old Rose in what James Cameron Best Picture winner? Saying it would have been a torturous experience, 90-year-old Scream Queen Faye Ray passed on the role of Old Rose in what James Cameron Best Picture winner? Round four, question number two. Number two, Steve Reeves reportedly put on 19 pounds of muscle in the month before he nabbed what pan-galactic title later held by Mr. Ferrigno and Schwarzenegger? Steve Reeves reportedly put on 19 pounds of muscle in the month before he nabbed what pan-galactic title later held by Mr. Ferrigno and Schwarzenegger? well, Senior Muscly. Moving on, round four, question number three. Number three, in 1980's Flash Gordon earned a Worst Actor Award nomination for Sam J. Jones at the very first iteration of what bizarro Oscar Awards? 1980's Flash Gordon earned a Worst Actor Award nomination for Sam J. Jones at the very first iteration of what bizarro Oscar Awards? Love a good C-Lab reference. Thank you, Eric the Jewish Viking. I needed a good laugh. Question number four of round four. RKO Pictures is still around. Kinda. Their most recent film was 2015's Barely Lethal, starring what Stark sister and former Mrs. Joe Jonas? RKO Pictures is still around. Kinda. Their most recent film was 2015's Barely Lethals, co-starring what Stark sister and former Mrs. Joe Jonas? Speaking of Haley Steinfeld, Prof. MDM, I rewatched True Grit this weekend, the 2010 Coen Brothers remake. I forgot Haley Steinfeld played the kid in that movie. She was like 12 or 13 when they made it. Jeez, I'm old. Moving on, question number five. Number five of round four, 1963's post-apocalyptic horror film Day of the Triffids. Was it about carnivorous plants or giant bugs? 1963's post-apocalyptic horror film Day of the Triffids, was it about carnivorous plants or giant bugs? It's a great movie, Gabbo. It's honestly one of my favorite westerns. I prefer the Coen Brothers remake to the original because, you know, John Wayne. Moving on, question number six. Number six, only a few months after the Bay of Pigs, a 1961 UN speech saw what president warn of a nuclear sword of Damocles? Only a few months after the Bay of Pigs, a 1961 UN speech saw what president warn of a nuclear sword of Damocles. Yeah, that feels more accurate, Jerifad. That feels a lot more accurate. And question number seven. Number seven, we're not lying. You're just crazy. Leo G. Carroll starred in the Broadway version of what psychological thriller that inspired Merriam-Webster's 2022 Word of the Year? We're not lying. You're just crazy. Leo G. Carroll starred in the Broadway version of what psychological thriller that inspired Merriam-Webster's 2022 Word of the Year? Pretty sure a nuclear bomb, TS Master, was Oppenheimer's greatest fear. Moving on to number eight. Question number 8. In 1980, an Iowa sheriff's office stumbled upon an old crash site evidence folder containing a pair of horn-rimmed glasses that once belonged to what singer? Number 8 again. In 1980, an Iowa sheriff's office stumbled upon an old crash site evidence folder containing a pair of horn-rimmed glasses that once belonged to what singer? And we're back to our next bonus question. Don't forget, winner of the bonus question gets a $5 credit for the Geeks Who Drink Shopatorium and entered into a drawing at the end of tonight's quiz to get a big ol' swag box. Do exclamation points and your answer in the chat. If you think the answer should be more than one word, remove any spaces, punctuations, etc. Smash them all together. So let's get to it with our bonus question for round 4. One of Lily St. Cyr's many indecency arrests happened in 1967 in what major Canadian city that was cleaning up its lewd corners for a big World's Fair expo? One of Lily St. Cyr's many indecency arrests happened in 67 in what major Canadian city that was cleaning up its lewd corners for a big World's Fair expo? I'm pretty sure everybody's got that figured out, so we're going to go over some answers for round number 4. You have until I read the answer for question number 7 to submit your bonus answer. Round number 4, question number 1, saying it would have been a torturous experience. 90-year-old Scream Queen Faye Ray passed on the role of Old Rose in Titanic. Number 2, Steve Reeves reportedly put on 19 pounds of muscle in the month before he nabbed the title of Mr. Universe. Number 3, 1980's Flash Gordon earned a Worst Actor Award nomination for Sam J. Jones at the very first Golden Raspberries. Number 4, RKO Pictures, still around, kinda. Their most recent film was 2015's Barely Lethal, co-starring what Stark sister? That's Sophie Turner. Number 5, 1963's post-apocalyptic horror film, Day of the Triffids. It's about carnivorous plants, based on a novel also. Question number 6, only a few months after the Bay of Pigs, a 1961 UN speech saw what president warn of a nuclear sword of Damocles? That was John F. Kennedy. And number 7, we're not lying, you're just crazy. Leo G. Carroll starred in the Broadway version of what psychological thriller that inspired Merriam-Webster's 2022 Word of the Year? That's Gaslight. Number 8. In 1980, an Iowa sheriff's office stumbled upon an old crash site evidence folder containing a pair of horn-rimmed glasses that once belonged to the late, great Buddy Holly. And we are back to the bonus question. Time for the answer for that. One of Lily St. Cyr's many indecency arrests happened in 1967 in what major Canadian city that was cleaning up its lewd corners for a big World's Fair expo? That's Montreal. Montreal. Round number 5 is a video round. Now it's only worth 8 points, so if you still have a joker, you probably want to save them for round 6 or 7. Our theme for round 5 tonight is missed Connections. Missed Connections. It's National Puzzle Day. So to celebrate, name these video games that gave us some incredibly difficult and nearly unsolvable puzzles. Just name the video games. I'm going to run all 8 clips for you twice back to back. Let's go through them now.
As it is to imagine, there actually is a solution, devilishly hidden. Oh, yes. Oh, well done. Oh, that's...
No, I'm just messing with you. Nothing froze. All right, we are back. We're going to go over the answers to round number five right now. Round number five was Missed Connections. I love that title. I love the title for that round, Missed Connections. Number one, well, that's Pokemon. Number two, that's the Batman Arkham series from Rocksteady. No, I am not buying Suicide Squad. Number three, that's Banjo-Kazooie. Number four, that's The Elder Scrolls. Number five, one of the best game series ever made, it's Portal. Specifically, that's Portal 2. Number six, that is Undertale. Number seven, that is the Professor Layton series. And number eight, that's The Legend of Zelda. That is the end of our answers for round number five. We're going to move on to round six. As I mentioned, no, I will not be buying Suicide Squad. I hate live service games, and I'm really bummed that they made it a live service game. Also, how are you going to have Captain Boomerang in your game and have him shooting machine guns instead of throwing boomerangs? I don't get it. I literally don't get it. Don't understand it. Also, when they're done porting all of the Phoenix Wright games to current generations, can they update and port over all the Professor Layton games as well? Those were a lot of fun. All right, let's get into round six. Round six tonight is our second 16-point round, so it's a good round to think about using your Joker for. Otherwise, round seven, our final round of the evening, is also a 16-point round. Our theme for round six tonight is Dak Cluedo Movie Edition. Dak Cluedo Movie Edition. It is movie murder time. Every question lists a killer, a location, and a manner of death. For 1 point, name the movie. For another point, name the victim. And because we like you, we'll accept either the actor or the character name for the victim. It's movie murder time. Each question lists a killer, location, and manner of death. For 1 point, name the movie. For another point, name the victim. Because we like you, we'll accept either the actor or the character name for the victim. For example, 2019, Thor at a tranquil cabin on Titan 2 with a giant axe. That'd be Avengers Endgame, and the victim would be Thanos, and we would also accept Josh Brolin. All right, let's get into it with number one. Number one, 2007, Daniel Plainview in his mansion's private bowling alley with the old-timey bowling pin. 2007, Daniel Plainview in his mansion's private bowling alley with the old-timey bowling pin. Big Red Frack, they still have the Miles Edgeworth games to port, and I really hope they do port the Miles Edgeworth games over. They're part of the Phoenix Wright series, and only one of them was originally translated into English, so there are two other games that I've never gotten to play. So please, God, release a Miles Edgeworth trilogy. And then when you're done with that, you can do all the Professor Layton's as well and continue taking my money. Question number two. Number two, 1991, Sarah Connor and T-800 in the steel mill with the grenade launcher. 1991, Sarah Connor and T-800 in the steel mill with the grenade launcher. Remember, we want the title of the film, and we want the victim or the actor who played the victim. Jarfad, not only are most games live service games, but in particular when it comes to Suicide Squad, it just looks really bad. And the people who played the betas and all of the previews, like, nobody's really had anything great to say about it. And I will say again, how are you going to have Captain Boomerang in a game and not have him throw boomerangs? Question number three. Number three, 2009, Dr. Manhattan in Antarctica with the mind-powered body explosion. 2009, Dr. Manhattan in Antarctica with the mind-powered body explosion. Destiny every once in a while, Jarfad. I get a wild hair, but honestly, like, I prefer single-player games. I prefer story-driven games. You give me a nice single-player, like, 20 or 30-hour story game, and you automatically get my money. Moving on, question number four. Number four, 1996. Ghostface in the first 12 minutes of the film with the big ol' hunting knife. 1996, Ghostface in the first 12 minutes of the film with the big ol' hunting knife. Don't forget, we want the title of the movie as well as the victim, and we will accept the actor playing the victim. Big Red Frack. Yeah, no, I was tempted to import the Miles Edgeworth games until I realized that there were no actual English translations on the cart. Some Japanese games have English translations directly on the cart, so they're completely importable, but those were not games that were. Question number five. Number five of round six. 2021, the HMS Dragon at Safin's secret headquarters in the Sea of Japan with the barrage of missiles. 2021, the HMS Dragon at Safin's secret headquarters in the Sea of Japan with the barrage of missiles. And I played the original Phoenix Wright games on Nintendo DS. I do have them on my Switch. I also have the great Ace Attorney, and those are a lot of fun. I need to pick up the Apollo Justice trilogy because I actually never played those ones. I'll get to it at some point, probably later this year. Moving on, question number six. Number six, 1994. Newly retired boxer Butch Coolidge coming out of the bathroom with a machine gun left by the toaster. 1994, newly retired boxer Butch Coolidge coming out of the bathroom with a machine gun left by the toaster. And second to last question of round six, number seven. Question number seven, 1983. Alejandro Sosa's hitman, the Skull, on the gaudy indoor balcony with shotgun to the back. 1983, Alejandro Sosa's hitman, the Skull, on the gaudy indoor balcony with the shotgun to the back. And question number 8. Number 8, 2022. M. Haywood over Jupiter's claim near the family ranch with the exploding Jupe balloon. Sorry, no actor for this one. 2022, M. Haywood over Jupiter's claim near the family ranch with the exploding Jupe balloon. And sorry, no actor for this one. That is the end of round 6. It means time for our next bonus question. Bonus question winners get a $5 credit for the Geeks of Drink Shopatorium and entered into a drawing at the end of the night for a big old Geeks of Drink swag box. Do exclamation points and your answer in the chat if you think your answer should be more than one word. Remove any spaces, punctuation, and just mash it all together. All right, bonus question. 1933. The same movie and victim. Four pilots on the Empire State Building with the biplane gunfire and beauty when you think about it. 1933, the same movie and victim. Four pilots on the Empire State Building with the biplane gunfire and beauty when you think about it. Looks like you guys got that one all figured out, so why don't we go ahead and go over some correct answers for round number 6. That's Dat Cluedo Movie Edition. Number 1. 2007, Daniel Plainview in his mansion's private bowling alley with the old-timey bowling pin. The movie is There Will Be Blood. And that's Eli Sunday, played by Paul Dano. Number 2, 91, Sarah Connor in the T-800 in the steel mill with the grenade launcher. That is T-2 Judgment Day. That's T-1000 or Robert Patrick. Number 3, 09, Dr. Manhattan in Antarctica with the mind-powered body explosion. That's Watchmen. That'd be Rorschach or Jackie Earl Haley. Number 4, 96, Ghostface in the first 12 minutes of the film with the big ol' hunting knife. That is Scream. It's the original Scream, not any of the 8 other movies that were titled simply Scream. That is Casey Becker, played by Drew Barrymore. Number 5, the HMS Dragon at Safin's secret headquarters in the Sea of Japan with the barrage of missiles. That's 2021. That is No Time to Die. That's James Bond, played by Daniel Craig. Number 6, 94, newly retired boxer Butch Coolidge coming out of the bathroom with a machine gun left by the toaster. It'd be Pulp Fiction. It's Vincent Vega, played by John Travolta. Number 7, 1983, Alejandro Sosa's hitman the Skull on the gaudy indoor balcony with the shotgun to the back. That is Scarface. And Tony Montana, played by Al Pacino. And number 8, M. Haywood over Jupiter's claim near the family ranch with the exploding Jupe balloon. There's no actor for this one. The movie was Nope. The victim was Jean Jacket. And we are back to the bonus question. Bonus question answer time. 1933, the same movie and victim. Four pilots on the Empire State Building with the biplane gunfire and beauty. When you think about it, that's King Kong. King Kong. Final round, random knowledge. It's worth 16 possible points. Some of the questions are going to have multiple parts. Some are going to be worth multiple points. Make sure you pay close attention to each question. More time, final round, random knowledge worth 16 possible points. Some of the questions are going to have multiple parts. Some are going to be worth multiple points. Make sure you pay close attention to each question. Random knowledge question number one. Number one, it's worth 1 point. 1 point. By using devices that could only measure up to the not great, not terrible level of 3.6 Roentgen, Alexander Akimov made what 1986 disaster a whole lot worse? By using devices that could only measure up to the not great, not terrible level of 3.6 Roentgen, Alexander Akimov made what 1986 disaster a whole lot worse? Moving on, final round, question number two. Number two is worth 2 points. 2 points. In what European country does Lower Saxony lie almost entirely north of Saxony? And for a second point, South Tyrol is actually the northernmost province in what other European country? Number two again, 2 points. In what European country does Lower Saxony lie almost entirely north of Saxony? And for a second point, South Tyrol is actually the northernmost province in what other European country? Final round. Question number three. Number three is worth 1 point. 1 point question. A pizza fan who won't touch deep dish. What New York director anagrams to sleek pie? A pizza fan who won't touch deep dish. What New York director anagrams to sleek pie? Moving on, final round, question number four. Number four, it's going to be worth 3 points. 3 points for each minor league team you name their predictable major league affiliate. For each minor league team you name their predictable major league affiliate. First, the Greensboro Swarm in basketball. Second, the Sugar Land Space Cowboys in baseball. And third, Henderson Silver Knights in hockey. 3 points for each minor league team you name their predictable major league affiliate. First, the Greensboro Swarm in basketball. Second, the Sugar Land Space Cowboys in baseball. And third, Henderson Silver Knights in hockey. midway point of the final round. Don't forget, if you didn't use your joker earlier in the quiz, you have to use it on the final round, because we don't let you take him home and bring him back for next week, no matter what any of the veteran players tell you in the chat. Question number 5. Though it's restricted to non-Muslim diplomats, the first liquor store in 70 years opened last week in what Mideast kingdom? Number 5, it's a 1-point question. Though it's restricted to non-Muslim diplomats, the first liquor store in 70 years opened last week in what Mideast kingdom? Farfetch DNW, this is an artist called named Harris Heller. The music falls under his label Stream Beats, and it's all free music that people can use for streams. If you are a streamer or ever have reason to stream and you need background music, I recommend Stream Beats because they are all public domain and you're able to use them however you'd like. Moving on, question number 6 of the final round. Number 6, 3-point question. Is it a Hunter S. Thompson book or an episode of Bluey? 3 points, is it a Hunter S. Thompson book or an episode of Bluey? First, Granny Mobile. Second, Pass the Parcel. Third, The Curse of Lano. 3 points, is it a Hunter S. Thompson book or an episode of Bluey? Granny Mobile, Pass the Parcel, The Curse of Lano. And everyone's saying, like, these places have the best pizza. You're all wrong. The best pizza is New York City. Moving on, question number 7. Number 7 is a 1-point question. Long considered inferior to Arabica coffee beans. Savier magazine called the rise of what sturdy sounding species the 2023 coffee trend nobody saw coming. Long considered inferior to Arabica coffee beans, Savior magazine called the rise of what sturdy sounding species the 2023 coffee trend nobody saw coming. New York City is not the coward's answer for best pizza. It is, in fact, just the correct answer. Final question of the quiz, number 8. Number 8 is a 4-point question. Number 8 is a 4-point question. Delta, American, and United are the 3 largest U.S. airlines by revenue. Name any 4 of the next 5 largest. Hint, think cheap fares and no legroom. 4 points. Delta, American, and United are the 3 largest U.S. airlines by revenue. Name any of the 4 of the next 5 largest. Think cheap fares and no legroom. Taco pizza is best pizza. Hot dogs are not pizza, they are tacos. All right, everybody, it is time for our final bonus question of the evening. Bonus question winners get a $5 credit to use the Geeks Drink Shopatorium and entered into a drawing at the end of the night for a big ol' Geeks Drink swag box. Do exclamation point and your answer in the chat if you think your answer should be more than one word. Remove any spaces, punctuation, etc., and just mash it all together. Until 2020, what website let you post by sending a text message to the number 40404? Until 2020, what website let you post by sending a text message to the number 40404? Alright, looks like you guys have that all figured out, so you have until I read the answer for round 7, question 7, to submit a bonus answer. Final round answers, starting with question number 1. Number 1, by using devices that could only measure up to the not great, not terrible level of 3.6 erosion, Alexander Akimov made what 1986 disaster a whole lot worse? That's Chernobyl. Number 2, 2 points. In what European country does Lower Saxony lie almost entirely north of Saxony? That's Germany. And South Tyrol is actually the northernmost province. In what other European country? Well, that's Italy. Number 3, a pizza fan who won't touch deep dish. What New York director anagrams to sleek pie? That's Spike Lee, a New Yorker with good taste. Number 4, 3 points. Name each minor league team from their affiliate. The Greensboro Swarm in basketball. That's the Charlotte Hornets. The Sugarland Space Cowboys in baseball. That's the Houston Astros. And the Henderson Silver Knights in hockey. That's the Vegas Golden Knights. Question number 5, though it's restricted to non-Muslim diplomats, the first liquor store in 70 years opened last week in Saudi Arabia. Question number 6, 3 points. Hunter S. Thompson book or Bluey episode? Granny Mobile? That's a Bluey episode. Pass the Parcel? That's also a Bluey episode. The Curse of Llano? Well, that's a Hunter S. Thompson book, and that's got some beautiful illustrations by Ralph Steadman. Question number 7, long considered inferior to Arabica coffee beans, Savier magazine called the rise of what sturdy-sounding species the 2023 coffee trend that nobody saw coming? That is Robusta. Robusta. And number 8, Delta, American, and United are the three largest U.S. airlines by revenue. Name any 4 of the next 5 largest. They are Southwest, Alaska, JetBlue, and Spirit. And the 5th one would be Frontier. Southwest, Alaska, JetBlue, Spirit, Frontier. I have flown all of those airlines, and yeah, that was a choice every time. Let's get to the bonus question answer. Final bonus question answer of the evening. Until 2020, what website let you post by sending a text message to the number 40404? That'd be Twitter, or I guess X. We didn't take X as an answer, but I guess it's X now. Thank you so much to everybody who hung around while we had a lot of technical difficulties for a little while. I hope the rest of the quiz was fun for you. Until next time, I am your host. I have been AJ. This has been Geeks Who Drink, and as always, we're awesome.